Inside was a scrap of journal. In the orchard, I meet the stranger from the cook's fire, a stranger no longer. Together, we fill their satchel, food and memories for the road ahead. The stranger was afraid. They couldn't see what lay ahead. Ember saw their own fear reflected in the stranger. The darkness hungered for them all. Little Ember spoke hesitantly. How do you continue, never knowing if we'll reach the end? The pot had turned cold. The fire had died. Nothing the cook made felt good enough. Endlessly stirring the same tasteless pot. Couldn't focus, sleepwalking through the days. Aimed inwards was a swirl of thoughts. In the eye of the storm, a fragile flicker. They wanted to serve something perfect. Couldn't hold on. The praise of others was hollow. Hold on. The cook felt numb and hurt all at once. Thank you. cook spoke softly. Oh, hello, little one. I didn't see you. I must have lost myself for a moment. It's supposed to be my new soup recipe. But it's not ready. It's not done. A wonderful smell wafted towards Ember. You look starving, poor thing. Have a little taste, but it's not right yet. It was the most beautiful thing Ember had ever tasted. I know. It's got no flavor, nothing special. Ember wished the cook would believe them. Oh, I'd forgotten how good it feels feeding folk. But it's not ready. There's no need to pretend just to make me feel better. The cook stirred their soup, looking at Ember, looking at their pot, staring, thinking. Soon, maybe. Oh, I used to love this. Just want to be good at it. But it feels like I'm making the same things over and over. Nothing has flavor. I'm stuck. If you know what you want, I can try. But I really need some better ingredients. Something from the orchard could have worked, if it was still standing. Oh, the cook struggled to hold back their emotions. Pigs have gotten in me orchard. Planted every sapling I did. All me hard work ruined. Take the key and have a look yourself. I can't bear to. See if anything is left, but I promise you, there won't be. Stone golem frozen in the lake, a relic from a forgotten time. Ember watched as the helpful piggy cleared the path. The Wanderer's Diary. An ancient throne sits empty. No one remains to guide or protect, but we do not mind. My companion shelters with me now. We cannot help those left behind. The stranger couldn't take on more. Time to grow had passed. I settled into the soft moss and waited. The stranger stretched their limbs. Perhaps it is not too late after all. Ember found the Wanderer's diary. We stop by the warmth of another campfire. The guardian spirit provokes us, asks what we hope to resolve. I do not understand the question. My companion is silent. Ember uncovered a journal entry. Snorty piggy, simple piggy, so easily teased with fruit. They are no help until they are fed. A few grow fat, wobbling on their trotters. Hidden away was a scrap of journal. Hands encircled around the evening fire, merry lanthorn tunes, singing out the promises of old. Will home be as we remember? The orchard gate was locked and needed a key. Ember placed the key in the lock and slowly began to turn it. The cook was right. The pigs had destroyed everything. The pig was stuffed to bursting, having filled up on fruit in the orchard. The pig devoured the fruit with careless abandon. The frog seemed nervous, but also relieved to see Ember. They told Ember that the birds had let all the pigs into the orchard, and that the pigs had eaten everything. all whilst the birds watched and laughed. Except one precious thing the frog had managed to keep safe. The frog offered the lotus seeds to Ember. They pleaded for Ember to take the lotus seeds to their old friend, the cook, as the frog knew how important good ingredients were in hard times. The stranger closed their eyes and let the fog overwhelm them. Soft, gentle fog, it held them like a vice. The mist could not be pushed, would not be fanned away. The stranger spoke. The fog didn't choose me, it just was. I hope it never closes on you, friend. Ember found a scrap of journal. The lanthorn wards off ghosts and fear. It shapes the world as we wish it. I urge my companion to rest, but still they stare into the fire. The frog seemed nervous, but also relieved to see Ember. They told Ember that the birds and that the pigs had eaten everything, all whilst the birds watched, except one precious thing. The frog offered the lotus seeds to Ember. They pleaded for Ember, as the frog knew how important good ingredients were in hard times. So soon? I can't believe... Where did you... I've never cooked with lotus seeds before. Ember felt happy seeing the cook suddenly so full of purpose. What a lovely surprise! What a lovely surprise! Please try some. It's not much, but there's plenty to go around. Help yourself. Be well, little one. And do remember me if you are ever hungry. Was joyous. What is this morsel? My insides feel as refreshed as my outsides. I did not dream such food was possible. We will plant a garden of treats. We will grow and eat like picky kings. Compliments to the chef. Hidden inside was the Wanderer's journal. Our feet are weary, the hours long. There will be much to do when we arrive. I tell my companion of those waiting at home. They do not seem to know what to say. The stranger couldn't face themselves. It never meant any harm. The stranger couldn't face themselves. The stranger couldn't face themselves. To be outshone. Easier just to turn aside. The stranger searched Ember's face. Is there hope for me, do you think? Will I make it? Thank you. Inside was a secret diary entry. The satchel is almost bare, our supplies exhausted. The taste of a good meal is not easily forgotten, but it slipped my mind to thank the cook. Ghost said, "You have done all you can, little one. Your journey lies ahead. You have done well to get this far, little one. I will clear the path ahead for you." You have seen another watching over you. They know the secrets of this place. Seek them out. The painting was the same as Ember had seen before. Two embers shone clearly in the daylight now, their journey ahead. Well now, we've been looking everywhere for you. Oh, fun, fun, over the wall they goes. Hope you have a good excuse for running off, Scab. Ember's heart sank. Ember told the birds about all they had seen in the marsh, pleading for their help. Save your made-up stories for the Forest King. Oh yes, yes, tell the lies to the king. Ember felt nervous standing before the king again. Frustrated, the Forest King said, "Poor tired Ember, where did you go? You must rest now."
"You give false hope, try and fail and hurt. This is all there is."
Ember could feel the Forest King looking right through them.
"This end, there no more. Why not stop? Let go of this. You must stay. No more foolish hope. Last chance. Take key now. Make sure gates are locked. Let no more in. Let no more out."
Ember took the key. What choice did they have? Yeah, this really is your last chance. Don't betray the Forest King again. The Ember looked proud. I've nearly earned my full feathers. How are you getting on? The ember hesitated. Oh, really well. Me too. I can't wait until everyone has to listen to me. Yeah. The traveler looked lost. Have you been searching for home too? I wandered so long. But something feels wrong out there. I'm not sure it feels right here either. The stranger inhaled deeply. The cook taught me this recipe. Don't tell anyone, but the secret ingredient is pork. The stranger spoke earnestly. The forest king is right, you know. I've seen those embers turned forlorn. It's a shame they wouldn't listen. The crossroads gate was locked. Ember placed the key in the lock and slowly began to turn it. Eagerly, Ember left the birds behind, glad to be free. The traveler whispered, "Used to be a river all round here. Watched the birds build the dam night and day. Took them forever. They had no clue what they were doing. It was hilarious." Ember was at the entrance to a dark cave. The smell of stale water oozed out, like it had once been flooded, but now was bone dry. Excitedly, the stranger said, "Look, it's Iron Claw." Friend, this crab is the terror of the marsh. Together we can trap him. I've got a plan. Been waiting for someone to help. You help me, and I'll help you. Try lowering the crab over here with the chum in that bucket. He can only see what's right in front of him. A lost message was inside. Our music crafts our path, bridging over any we pass. My companion's hand clutches mine. We dart like fireflies through the swamp. Crab is all yours. Didn't plan any further than this. Look at that claw, though, friend. Could do some real damage. Ember found a secret note from the Wanderer. A memory laps at the edge of my dreams. A time before the water, someone I wished to stay for. We must hurry home. Ember thought of the pigs from the marsh. Someone had tightly sealed the dam's mouth. Ember wondered what secrets it might spill. Forlorn was not the same as the others, flinching at Ember's approach. The stranger spoke. I don't want your help. I'm not ready to let go of how I'm feeling. With regret, Ember moved on. The stranger pondered. I just wanted to fix things, to help get the water flowing again. But I have absolutely no idea what I'm doing. The bellows breathed life into the fire beneath the boiler. But it would take more air to fully stoke the fire. Did something? I think there's one more of those valve things. You did it. I hope we don't get in trouble for this. What a satisfying rush the damn water burst. Ember really did hope they wouldn't be in trouble. ember found a lost message. To see hope fade in those you care for. The harder I squeeze, the quicker it slips away. Everything flooded again. Ember wondered if now they could reach the entrance of the cave. Freed from the mud, the boat looked inviting. The boat was a perfect fit for Ember. It felt like they were on the right path at last. Inside was a scrap of journal. Less and less grows here. I dare not go in the caves alone. The spiders whisper. Their cobwebs glitter. I am not sure I am ready. The passageway was dark and eerily silent. Ember wondered why the dam had been blocked. There was a lens on the wall. It looked dull in the darkness. There was a space in the frame for something to fit. It looked like the crystal could be turned, but the handles were retracted. The Wanderer's Diary. Frogs play at the feet of fallen statues. Simple, splashy, happy little hoppers. They seem content in the home they've made. As the gate opened, a thought occurred. What was the gate keeping locked away? Ember had found another unlit campfire at the heart of the cave. The ghost said, "Speak and I will listen." This is the cave of regret. Fear would not allow hope to find a perch here. You must not lose hope, or you too will turn forlorn. Ember thought of those they loved, those they'd left behind. There are others lost along their journey. Find them and I will guide them. The Forest King watches the doors. The campfire will light the way. Find those who are lost. Bring embers to the fire. Not far from this campfire, a path runs north. Where the pathway ends, a forlorn lies helpless. The stranger seemed troubled. I ran away from those birds, but I can't find the end. The Forest King offered me a feather. Maybe I should just take it. Shadow moved in the distance. The stranger muttered. Another lanthorn player. Well, I'm not falling for that again. Ember found the Wanderer's diary. The earth resists my wishes. The lanthorn will not answer when I blow. I must be rid of it. I hide the wretched instrument deep in a riddle. The creature's body slithered between the rocks, seeming to never end. The stranger was wary, coiled and tense. The dark had gifted them friends in the past. The dark had stolen much more. Would this new light do the same? Stranger whispered, "I'm so tired. Do you know the way?" The stranger was tired of pretending. fortune had always favored them.
Thank you.
They'd never have made it on their own. They deserve to make it this far? Stranger spoke simply. Thank you. Ember uncovered a journal entry. I dock my boat at the final harbor. Soft drips drip dripping over slick black rock. Something hisses from the dark. The stranger whispered. Seen one just like you around here a lot. Creepy that one is. Peeping out, watching you. Yeah, watching you. Specifically you. Ember felt pity for the skeleton. Without a flower to mark their grave. Ember had nothing to offer. The stranger had misplaced a memory. They tried to remember, but found more voids. only the shape of the thought remained. The stranger looked around fearfully. I stayed in the nest too long. The spindle was missing a handle, so Ember couldn't turn it. Terror gripped Ember suddenly. Fear overwhelmed them. Splintered plank was all that remained of Ember's boat. They sat for a moment and despaired. Perhaps the Forest King was right. There was no hope here. A discarded builder robot. The poor thing was rusted in place. The builder's thoughts were stuck in a loop. Turning slowly to rust, only the echoes for company. Disconnected gears in their head turning round and round. Each unshared moment went the same. Lost and uncared for was a dim glow. The years of loneliness had warped the builder's feelings. Perhaps they should be alone. Time spent with others felt like a false memory. The soundless days measured piece by piece. Who's there? I can't see. It's dark. I'm ever so afraid. Keep talking to me, please. My eye. The feathered ones did this to me. It's been so long since I've seen anyone. Since I've talked to anyone. I can feel the warmth of the sun on it. An outside place. It's okay if you don't want to help. But it would be so nice to see what you look like. It was wonderful to meet you. Don't forget me, please. The others never came back. Hidden away was a scrap of journal. The snake is drawn to the light. They are not so fearsome after all. I think they mean no harm. Took a moment as they tried to focus their eye on the small blue figure in front of them. So that's what you look like. I don't know what I expected, but you have a kind face. Sorry, I don't mean to make you uncomfortable. It's just been so long since I've seen anyone. I've never been good at talking to others. You seem different somehow. Wait, how did you get here? Oh, that's unfortunate. You'll be stuck here without a... The builders seem to have an idea. You know, maybe I can help you. This is so exciting. This is what I was made for. It's been so long since I made something for someone. Ember watched in amazement. Could I get your input for a moment? The scraps of broken wood and metal were being transformed. Whatever the builder was making was nearly ready. I really hope you like it. Oh, it's a bit rough around the edges. Definitely seaworthy. You hate it, don't you? Ember stood in stunned silence. That is such a relief. Really warms my pistons. I'm so happy. Oh no. I'm not... Well, that's very kind of you. Truly, I would if I could. But if you see any others, perhaps ask them to visit the builder. Ember would come back if they could. Perhaps the builder just needed more time. The boat was a little unconventional, but Ember already loved it. Ember felt pity for the skeleton, without a flower to mark their grave. Ember found a scrap of journal. In the dark, I slip and stumble, land hard upon my knee. Without thinking, I reach for an absent hand